The sweet sound of skeletons dying. Is anything else as awesome as that? I don't think so. Okay, so we want to bring these skeletons up. So I think probably right here is where I'm going to start my tube going up. In order to do this... Yeah, I'm going to need more signs than that. Okay, going back to the base, going to grab some signs. Okay guys, I'm back. Made a whole bunch of signs. Put an infinite water pool here. Not quite sure exactly how this is going to work, but I think I have a pretty good idea. Just need to build this up like this. Okay, so... I think... I might have just screwed that up. Yeah, so... The way this works is we're going to have a source block of water every other square. This bottom is going to be a sign. The skeletons are going to hit this, they're going to hit the water and they're going to want to float up, I believe. So we do that. We're going to need a sign right there to prevent water flowing backwards. Get more signs in my inventory. It's gonna be like that. No, I need. Okay, water. Break through here. So that's gonna be a sign. That's gonna be closed up. More water. Okay, so... Not sure if that's actually where I want it, but I can move it later. Let's just get this pretty much fleshed out. Okay, water. Sign. I think for now I'm going to use glass so we can see what's going on here. And then I'm going to want, I believe, a sign here. You grab some more water. I'm gonna put water right here. Ooh. Right, okay. Not exactly what I was hoping for. There's gonna be a sign at the bottom. Okay. So this water should push them out. Then we're going to want more water. Go down and grab some more. Like that. Actually, I think I need to move this up one more level. Yeah, I don't think this is gonna work like that. Let's make the infinite water pool up here. This needs to come back. So like that, I think we're going to have a sign there. I think that might be right. I think I need to put a sign there. And get rid of this one. Block this up. The water there. So that should push them this way. I think this needs to be blocked up. So they should float up here. They're gonna keep floating up until they get to this point. This water current is moving this way, it should pull them over. Then they're gonna hit this water current, which is gonna pull them over more. Here, I believe this square is where we need the lava. Let's see, okay, so if we put the lava there, we are going to need I think that like that. This needs to come out. I think we're going to need a sign right there. This needs to be covered up. So the lava is going to be right there. They're going to die. The water should... the drop should end up right here. I'm going to extend this out just a bit more for now. Probably glass like that. Now it's going to be the interesting part, is actually getting rid of the lava. Letting him flow through this thing. Okay, that's not what I wanted to do. That's not right. Oh no. Lava everywhere. Oh man, trail and error. Yeah, let's kill this off. Let the items flow through here. That seems to be working the way I want it. Not so sure about this lava though. Now we got a nice little viewing booth of them dying. Okay, just wanted to give a shout out to Anders312. He had suggested that I actually change this setup and have the skeletons, you know, flow up some kind of a staircase path to my base so they all collect there. I pointed out the problem to him that these spawners actually don't spawn skeletons unless you're relatively close. Like, I think if I'm about this far away, they'll stop spawning altogether. And that's, you know, not even close to my base. So, thinking about his idea, I pretty much, you know, came up with this sort of a method instead of standing down there by my grinder, bringing the skeletons up through some kind of a path and then having them die up here. So I just, you know, wanted to give a shout out to him saying thanks for the idea. Even though it wasn't exactly what I used, it inspired me to go with this method. Okay, this is looking pretty good so far. I think I want to go ahead and bring this up to match. Let's see here. I said I was going to leave this pretty much hollow inside, so this was going to be more for aesthetics. But I'm going to actually open it up all the way and just leave a block on top of the spawner so mobs can't spawn on top of the spawner and just kind of hang out there, because I've had that problem before with ceilings too high above these things. So that's just going to be temporary. Yeah, I think that needs block. Okay. No, that's gotta be smooth stone. What am I doing? There we go. Okay, I think that's pretty much what I was trying to accomplish. Oh no, my pick. Dang it. Okay, time to make a quick stone pick. Just like that. Okay. Let's fix this up. Just like that. Like that. Alright. Now I think I'm going to change out the floor for regular stone. We'll grab some of that. Yeah, that should be plenty. I don't know if I'm going to keep the subfloor or keep a pathway down to it. I don't know if there's actually... Well, I guess there would be a reason to get to this stuff. Maybe I'll do like a hatch. We'll see. Let's start clearing this stuff out. Maybe leave one screen. Oh, I forgot I still got a stone pick. This is gonna suck. I should probably just go back to the main base and get another diamond pick. Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that, and I'll be right back. If you ever looked up fun in the dictionary, there would probably be an image of somebody replacing a cobblestone floor with smoothstone. Hey guys, I made a couple more changes to this thing. I adjusted where the water was. This used to be a water source block here, now it's a sign. So I just basically moved them all down or up, or just changed the position of all these different blocks. This is one single source block of water that travels over one, down one, over one. Basically, when the skeletons float up here, just keeps them moving all the way into the lava. I adjusted the collection point, remove the half steps that I tried out, and preference of just a single pressure plate. I think it makes it look a lot nicer. So if you guys have any other suggestions for future projects, something for me to work on, something you'd like to see me work on, let me know. I think that's probably going to wrap it up for today, guys. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next time.